So welcome back again. Good morning, students. So now we are resuming the topic of our grinding wheel. This is part two of this video. The part one of this video is consisting of the various things related to grinding wheels, that is abrasives. What are the types of abrasives? What is the grit grain size and what are the softness and hardness of the grinding wheels? Those has been covered already. So now we are continuing with the ISO standard for notation of the grinding wheels. So specification or nomenclature of grinding wheel, the Indian Standard Marking System IS SS1 1954 has been used to indicate the various characteristics of grinding wheel. Each marking consists of six symbols denoting the following characteristics. So these are the characteristics that we are going to consider while going for notation of the grinding wheel. First is abrasive. What is the type of abrasive that we are using? Second is grain size. Now, in the previous video, we have seen what is the meaning of grain size. In the previous video, we have also seen what is the meaning of grade, structure of grinding wheel, bond type, which type of bond the grinding wheel is comprising of, then manufacturer's record means what is the manufacturer name, when it is manufactured, where it is manufactured. All these things will be given in the part number six. So generally, this is the way the notation of grinding wheel is given: WA30I4V17. So each of the number or each of the digit, each of the alphabet given over here is having certain type of meaning. Let us see one by one what are the various meaning or what is the meaning of this W, what is the meaning of this A, 30, I, 4, V and 17. So here W prefix is nothing but the manufacturer's abrasive type symbol. So now we have seen that A to Z type of abrasives. So here W is nothing but prefix, which is manufacturer abrasive type. Manufacturer will decide this W type of abrasive, and this first letter will denote what? Manufacturer's abrasive type of symbol. Then A is nothing but prefix for the abrasive, that is whether it is aluminium oxide, C for silicon carbide, D for diamond. So here it is A, means here the abrasive is what? Aluminium oxide. If here it is C, then it will be silicon carbide. Then 30, this is the letter 30. At this particular point, various types of grain sizes will be given. So 30 is the grain size here. So there are four types of grain sizes, that is coarse, medium, fine and very fine. So this we have seen what is the meaning of grain size in the previous lecture. So here coarse are nothing but 10, 12, 14, 16, 20, 24. Medium are nothing but 30, 36, 46, 54, 60. Fine grain size can be denoted by using 80, 100, 120, 150, 180. And very fine will be denoted by using 200, 250, sorry, 240, 280, 320, 400, 500 or 600. So here 30 is nothing but what? Grain size. W is the prefix for the manufacturer abrasive type. A is the abrasive, which type of abrasive that we are using. 30 is the grain size. Then there comes I. So here I is the grade of the grinding wheel. So grade is categorized into three parts, that is soft, medium and hard. So now we have seen that A is the very softest grade and Z is the very hardest grade of the abrasive that we have bounded on the periphery or on the surface of the grinding wheel. So here I is used for denoting the grade of the grinding wheel. So soft are from A to H, medium are from I to P and hard are from Q to Z. So these are the various grades of the grinding wheels. So that is denoted at this particular location, which is fourth location, by using letter I. So here I means what? Medium. Medium is the grade of this grinding wheel. If it is Z, then it will be hard grade, or W, then it will be hard grade. Then number four is here at the fifth location. So four here is the structure. Structure categorized in two parts, that is dense or open. Now, dense or open means what? The structure is nothing but the distance between the two abrasives. Whether we are going to mount the abrasive on the grinding wheel, so they are having definite type of structure, means they will be having certain distance between them. So dense distance means if they are very closely associated with each other, then those will fall under the dense structure, and if the distance is very large between the two abrasives, then they will fall in the category of the open structure. So dense structure is from 1 to 8 and open structure is from 9 to 15. So any structural number which is given the number below 8 or 8, then it will be a grinding wheel with the dense structure, and any structure number which is given from 9 to 15, that it will be a open type of structure. So you can see the denseness is increasing from 8 to 1 and openness is increasing from 9 to 15. Then the we have seen first, second, third, fourth, fifth. Now we are going to see sixth and seventh part. So sixth part is comprising of certain letter. Here the letter is given as V. So V is nothing but the bond type. So these bond types are nothing but the type of bond which are holding the grinding abrasives on the grinding wheel. So here V stands for vitrified bond, B will be resonoid bond, R will be rubber bond, E will be shellac bond, and S will be silicon bond. So we can use at this particular location V, B, R, E or S. Now what are these bonds? That I will be giving you a link in which these bonds will be discussed in detail. So I am not making video on these particular types of bonds that we are using for manufacturing of the grinding wheels, but that you can see from the different resource material provided to you. And the last part, 17. So here the last part is 17. So this 17 is nothing but it is the suffix for manufacturing abrasive type symbol. So here W was initially, this W was prefix for manufacturing abrasive type, and 17 is suffix for the manufacturing abrasive types. Okay, so sorry, this. So now this is the standard type of grinding wheel. If you are going to purchase certain grinding wheel, then this is the type of grinding wheel that you are going to get. Now how to read various details that are provided on the grinding wheel. So initially at the top or at here certain symbol will be given. You can easily understand from that these symbols will be made in order to give the brand of the grinding wheel. Then these are the EN536H, these are the test record for this grinding wheel. Then certain restrictions of use will be given over here. Expiry date of this grinding wheel, because the bond between the grinding wheel is going to expire, the bond of the abrasives that we have used is going to expire soon. So that will be having certain expiry date, that will be given over here. Then we are having 544, 45 by 324, these are the dimensions in mm for the grinding wheels. This particular part will have the specification mark. This particular location will be for the code number, and this particular mark will be for maximum operation speed of this grinding wheel, and ISO type will be given over here, and this is the mounting instructions that will be given over here. So at this particular location you have to mount the grinding wheel. So these are the various details that will be given on the standard type of grinding wheel. And whenever you are going to purchase a standard grinding wheel from the market, so according to your requirement you should see all these details on your grinding wheel. Now let us discuss applications of the grinding wheel. The main application of grinding wheel is to remove the material in the form of the tiny chips and make the surface smooth as much as possible. This you already know. The grinding machine is surface finishing machine in which grinding wheels are fixed. This is our tool for surface finish. So now grinding machine is our tool. Grinding wheel is our tool. So grinding wheel is mounted on what? Grinding machine on which the surface finishing machining is to be carried out. Even the grinding wheels are different types as discussed above, and there are used are different for the different purposes. We have seen different types of grinding wheels based on the shape and size of these grinding wheels, and these different types of grinding wheels will be used for different types of applications for the resharpening of the tool or for performing grinding operations. Grinding wheel bond type, we have seen this vitrified shellac, rubber bond, etc. So a bond is an abrasive material used to hold abrasive particles together. The bonding material does not cut during the grinding operation. Bonding material does not cut means what? The material which is bonding the particles, grinding particles or abrasive particles on the grinding wheel, that material is not responsible for performing cutting operation or removing any material from the surface. Its main function is to hold the grains together with varying degrees of strength. So its main purpose is what? To hold that particular abrasive material on the grinding wheel or on the surface of the grinding wheel. That is the main and sole purpose of the grinding wheel's bonding material. The different standard grinding wheel bonds are vitrified, resonite, silicate, shellac, rubber and metallic bonds. Factors affecting the selection of grinding wheels. If you want to select certain grinding wheels, then what will be the various factors that are affecting while selecting the grinding wheels? So those factors are: proper grinding wheel selection is essential to ensure that the required part quality is what is the part quality that you want to produce. Production rate, at which production rate you want to produce the grinded parts. The overall cost per part is achieved or not. So that these are the things that you have to consider while selecting the grinding wheel. And it is normally depends upon the several terms like the type of grinding operation we perform, grinding machine condition, requirement of surface finishing, shape and size of the workpiece and workpiece material. So let us see the difference between the grinding and the cutting wheel. So grinding wheel has a good strength in which avoids the cutting of improper shape and size. Whereas the cutting wheel, the normal cutting tool doesn't have abrasives, so it will not provide better finishing accuracy as grinding wheel provides. Then in grinding wheel, second point is the chance of wear and tear are high in cutting wheel, and a grinding wheel having low chances of wear and tear. Then price of grinding wheel is more and the price of cutting wheel is less than the grinding wheel. Okay, so these are the basic three different differences between the grinding and the cutting wheel. These are the references that I have used for making these slides. So mainly all the material is available on this learnmechanical.com. It is a very good site created by the student, or we can say a scholar who is preparing for exams. So I am referring this site, and this material is copied from this slide under the Creative Commons license. So I want to acknowledge that in this particular slide. So thank you very much, and let us prepare for the quiz based on these two videos. Thank you.